We are solving quadratic equations by the method of completing the square. So this is the general form of a quadratic equation, ax square plus bx plus c equal to zero. Solving by that method, we have to transfer c to the right hand side. So we say c to right hand side. So we have ax square plus bx is equal to, now here it is positive as you can see. So we add the additive inverse of positive c, which is negative c, to both sides, so that we have negative c here. Then we divide throughout by the coefficient of x square, which is a, so that we get x square plus bx a equal to minus c over a. Here we get half of the coefficient of x, and we square it, then we add it to both sides. Half of the coefficient of x, which is b over a, we square it, then we add it to both sides. So half of b over a is b over 2a. Then square of b over 2a is b square over 4a square. So we add it to both sides, so that we have x square plus b over a x is equal to, we add to both sides, we have plus b square over 4a square is equal to minus c over a plus b square over 4a square. Okay, once we have this, then we factorize the left hand side. We factorize the left hand side and also express the right hand side as one fraction. So factorizing this one, the left hand side, we have x plus half of this b over 2a, and we put it in. Square it. So this is actually this is x plus b over 2a are factors of this. These two are factors of this expression that we have on the left hand side. On the right hand side, we express as a single fraction, so we have the common denominator. Then we say a into this, we have 4a times negative c, we have minus 4ac, I plus this into the 1, by that one we have b square. It's now x over x plus b over 2a square is equal to this numerator can also be written as b square minus 4ac, as addition is commutative. So and subtraction are commutative. So this is the same as this. Now, at this point, we make x the subject of the formula. This x the subject of the formula. So we need to get rid of the power 2. The only way to get rid of the power 2 is by doing this. By introducing the square root. Now, this is an equation. Whatever you do on the left hand side, also do it on the right hand side. So okay, so introduce the square root on both sides, so that whatever will come out of the square root here will be positive or negative. Whatever will come out of the square root there, positive or negative. So now this root will go with the power 2, so that we shall have only x plus b over 2a, which will be equal to the square root is for both the numerator and the denominator, so we can easily distribute it to the numerator and the denominator as this. B square minus 4ac over now get the square roots of these two on the right hand side. So that we have x plus b over 2a is equal to plus or minus the square root of b square minus 4ac over, now the square root of 4a square is 2a. So easily write it there, 2a. We come to the left hand side, we transfer now this one to the right hand side by adding the additive inverse of b over 2a, which is negative b. So we shall have this negative, this one comes here, negative b over 2a. This will be the result of adding the additive inverse of to both sides here and here. The additive inverse of b over 2a, which is minus b. So minus b over 2a, even here on the right hand side, minus b over 2a. So that will remain with minus b over 2a. Okay. So plus or minus b square minus 4ac, also over 2a. And we could easily express these two fractions as a single fraction, so that the common denominator is 2a. 2a into 2a is 1, by negative b is negative b. Plus or minus, we maintain this, plus or minus, 2a into 2a is 1. By the whole lot of the numerator, we have the numerator coming back the way it was. Okay. So basically, x is equal to minus b plus or minus b square minus 4ac, the square root everything over 2a. Basically, this is what we call the quadratic key formula. Formula which can be used, or which is used to solve all quadratic equations. So as long as a particular equation is quadratic, you are solving for the unknown values, you can easily use this formula. Negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac, everything over 2a. Or as long as you know that the value of a is the coefficient of x squared, the value of b is the coefficient of x, and c is the constant. As long as you know those values, you just need to put them into, you substitute them into these unknowns, then you'll be able to find the unknown values. So actually, this is how we solve quadratic equations by the method of completing the square. Thank you for watching.